I mean, it's gone. It is all gone. I mean, what do you think I'm going to cook? I mean, where do you think I'm going to cook? I mean, I'm just here. I need to get ideas. So don't discriminate against me.
Alright, pigs work. They better come up with more advanced materials to build our structures with, because if birds can get through them with ease, well then I'm not gonna buy that shit anymore. That's just so stupid. Even weakling little birds can blast through them. Nah, I don't think I'm gonna do it anymore.
Calm down. Those birds have superpowers. I've built those structures with like the most sturdy material I can, and seeing how fast they can go through them and just decimate that shows how powerful they are. Force not to be reckoned.
Superpowers? What a bunch of baloney.
Yeah, superpowers? What kind of sci-fi fantasy land are you living in, Pitchwork? I've lost all faith in you. Yeah, I thought you were a scientist.
Tisk, tisk, tisk.
It is getting hard to keep my promises to all these pigs. I have to up my game if I want to be re-elected as one of the town's officials.
Listen to all their babbling. It's monotonous.
I know the King Pig will listen to me.
I'm the Foreman. I am the Foreman Pig. Everyone trusts me. And I like that. Oh, yeah. Forgot about you. Commander Porterhouse.
And King Smoothcheeks' little pet. I have to boost my game up. All these snobs are gonna listen to him.
Alright. Order in the court. The King Pig is coming. Everybody control yourselves.
Oh, brother. There he goes barking orders. I've heard one already. I can't see.
Pigsworth. Is there a problem here?
No. Commander Porterhouse, I just need to put on my glasses. Oh.
Look at yourself. You're getting loonier and loonier. You're going to retire, son.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I know. But don't worry. I'm fine. I'm perfectly fine. Oh, come on. Okay, that's fine.
Yes. Thank you, Commander Porterhouse.
Yes, sir.
I'll be taking over now.
Yes. Oh, yes, right.
Yes, very good.
Attention! Please! Bring your attention.
That's the farthest I can turn around.
To the King Pig. King Smoothcheeks III.
Yes, very well now. Majority of the piggy population are watching this virtually. I've invited you gentlemen in here
so that we can officially propose our new plan to get those eggs from the birds.
Before we begin, do we have any questions?
Actually, I have one. Why are we wasting our energy getting these three eggs that obviously aren't going to be ours too easily?
That is because our ancestors have never failed to capture eggs and eat them successfully. We never failed to do any of that. And I would hate for this to be the first, especially under my name. And if it's those birds are being guarded by five puny, angry birds, then I just couldn't live with it. So we must try our hardest to get these three eggs. If you like it or not, those eggs will be ours! Yeah, cool, but you do know that those birds, like, decimated our castle.
I find your lack of faith disturbing!
I'm just gonna
get right back.
Yes, very well.
Okay, Commander. Get the hoax.
Yes, sir! My soul!
You're pushing me off the ledge!
Huh?
Yes. The hoax, as you can see here.
Psst, Pigsworth, is this one of the ideas you proposed?
No, it's not. It's not the idea he said he would do. What is this trickery?
I can hear you over there, Pigsworth, and that's just what it is. Trickery. Probably the best trickery this old dynasty has ever done.
The commander and I have been collaborating with our kingdom's printing company, and we've been working on printing out egg cutouts as well as piggy cutouts so that we can fool those birds into wasting their time with all these hoaxes that we're going to be setting up across the piggy kingdom.
This right here is the mother hoax. It's supposed to take my place so that the birds, when they try to attack me, they'll actually be attacking this. So yeah, just gonna be wasting their time.
That reminds me, Corporal Screwtail will be out and about, writing down riddles, sending those birds on a goose chase, trying to find their precious eggs. Well, they'll be doing that. We shall feast on those eggs that we shall steal tomorrow night.
The Corporal already has a plan to attack the eggs ready. All we have to do is just wait and see if those eggs come our way.
Hey. Yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, I guess it's pretty good. Bravo.
Yes, long live King Smoothcheeks.
Woohoo. This is just blasphemous. I won't have it anymore. I object this.
Huh? What?
Ah, yes. Foreman Fuzzstache. Tell me, Foreman, what makes you pry? I feel as if ever since you promoted Commander Porterhouse, all what you've done to me is just walk all over me.
I've done so much. I've started revolutions here. I've been here for so long. 70 years to be exact. I've been your second-hand man, or pig, ever since I got promoted to sergeant. I've come so long. I'm a foreman. I remember when you actually looked up to me. It was as if we were brothers, you and I. And now you put me behind a corporal who's leagues behind me, and Commander Porterhouse, who was promoted to this high ranking like 2 years ago. And now a cutout of yourself?
We weren't brothers. We were hardly even friends. Listen, this is just how a kingdom develops. New and more advanced experienced people come in and they take your place. And then, you know what happens to that kingdom?
Yes, they fall apart.
What? Sir, are you alright? No, it's fine. Foreman, I see that your loyalty to this kingdom is dwindling.
You bet your ass it is. I'm gonna take my place back! What's he doing?
You might want to get back, sir.
Yeah, I think I might have to. If I can't take back my place with ease, I'm going to have to do it with force.
No, you can't kill me! I'm your king!
No, I'm not going to kill you, you dimwit. I'm going to kill little Porterhouse.
No! Stay back! Stay back until the hammer!
My king! Are you going to help me? Help!
Yeah, King Smoothcheeks. Are you gonna help your favorite commander?
I actually miss seeing this side of you, Foreman. That willingness to compete forcefully for my loyalty in you.
What? Security!
No one knows going to help you.
What? What is this? I don't understand. How did he survive that? How's he not dead? No. No. Don't hurt me. No.
What?
No, he's not dead?
Yes, I'm afraid he's actually not dead. Years ago, I... get off of me, Jesus Christ!
Okay, anyways. A few years ago, and by that I mean 20, he came to me. He was the only one in his family. He was only 15 years old. And he was sad. He was lonely. He was the only one in his family that actually continued to live on. And here he is now, surviving all sorts of horrible deaths.
Ah! No! No! Help!
I remember that day as if it was yesterday, him coming into my office and wanting some sort of serum that would give him eternal life. Oh! Oh my god. My back is broken.
Yes.
And ever since that day, I regret it. I just want to die. I don't want to live like it anymore. It hurts! It hurts to die over and over again. A few days ago, I got squashed by all that rubble. Those birds put up a fight. And I tried to put a fight back. But they were too great. I wish I could die. But I had to relive it all. Every day, the pain comes back and it torments me. I can't do it anymore. Sometimes I want to kill the old man. But after he saw what he did to me, he couldn't let this upon himself. He took me in as his child, as if I was his own, and he nurtured me so I cannot leave. But I am forever furious at what that happened, even though I asked for it. And if we keep doing this, I know that you will put me in the frontier. You will get me to beat the shit out of those stupid birds, and I'll just experience that death over and over again. I can't do it anymore. I just don't want to. It is going to hurt. I just want peace.
Your torment is very familiar to me. And since you put up with it, we are going to give you 2 eggs, and then I'll feast on the third.
Well, yes, I guess that makes up for it all.
Yeah, very nice, yeah!
So, it is official. We're going to use our hoax.
And it will work!
It's not safe here anymore.
Don't get me out of here, please.
It's just not safe anymore. It's just not safe for me anymore. What happened? I can't be here. I need to leave this house. I need to start a rebellion. Yes. I know that some people will listen to me. I know that my word got to a few people. At least some pigs had to have listened to me. Well, just wait until you see the look on King Pig's face. Where he sees a huge rebellion. So long!
Honey? Melissa, dear? Honey? What are you doing, honey, behind you? Leonard, I don't...
I don't believe I like how you're treating the foreman. You mean foreman Fuzzstache? Yes. I believe it's unfair, and he had some valid points. Honey, I don't want you to listen to what that old man has to say. He's very old. He's nearly 100 years old, and seeing him go that crazy in the court today really made me super anxious. I had to do what I had to do. What if he starts a rebellion? Well then, it'll all be under my control. Nothing bad's gonna happen. I swear to you. We have a baby coming on the way. So if anything bad happens, which I guarantee you it won't, then it'll all be on his shoulders. I mean, come on. Good night. Just be morning already. I'm so tired. I don't have to take the night shift. Maybe just a little should I wouldn't hurt. Where's the bar? There it is. Okay, man. Let's get ready. Go ahead and get out there. They're all sleeping. Come on. Psst, psst. You heard the pig. Coast is clear. Come on. Come on, each of you grab an egg. It's you. I knew you'd pesky pigs come back. Come here. Come grab a piece of me. His kid is next.
Is someone there? Is it morning already?
Let's get that bomb over there. Slingshot. I'll take this. Seems useful enough to damage the wirehouses. Could be a good weapon. The pesky's wards. Let's take these guys out. Let's go. All right. That's all of them. Let's get those eggs and leave the decoy. Take these delicious, scrumptious looking eggs now, shall we? All right, birdies. It's a pleasure doing business with you. Sorry it had to end like this.
Yeah, sorry it had to end like this. Have a nice time with this little riddle.
All right. Now come on, you lot. Hey, I have an idea. Bring me that hammer. I've been waiting a long, long time for this. For the piggy kingdom. Huh? Bye, British. Yeah, goodbye. I'm gonna miss you.
Headache, guys. What happened last night? Chuck fell asleep. Great. Just when I needed to start my day. Chuck. Chuck. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Dumbass, wake up. Oh, damn.
The pigs. The pigs, they came back.
Tell me about it. Feel like they came back, a splitting headache. I had a dream that they were here and they like jumped us.
It was just a dream.
Chuck?
Yeah?
Where are the other eggs?
They should all be in, oh my god.
Chuck, is this a trick?
No. No, it's not. Pigs were here.
Chuck. Fell asleep.
I feel like they made me fall asleep. They like knocked me unconscious. How'd they sneak up on you?
Okay, maybe I did fall asleep, but Chuck. Is that why I'm unconscious? Did they hit me? What did they hit me with?
I don't know.
I think they all got us. Alright guys, come on, wake up. Jake. Jay, Jim. You gotta wake up, pals.
Oh god.
Matilda, bomb. Come on, guys. We have a huge issue.
What happened?
The pigs. I saw them. They were here.
Yeah, we know. They took two of the eggs. Come on, let's get back to the nest. We need to know what's going on.
It's just, why would they leave one egg?
Wait, hold on. There's something weird about our last egg. I need to examine it.
Ew. This isn't an egg at all. It's just a spear of some sort. There's weird red goop all over it.
Here, let me see that. It's not red. It's pig ink. Hold on. Red, you're covering it. I need to see it. There's some wording on it. It's hard to make out. It's been years. Since I've read into this language, it's pig Latin. Hold on, let me translate it for a minute.
Pig Latin? What's that?
It just simply says, in the lap of the mountain.
What is that supposed to mean?
Wait, what's that little black streak right there?
Black streak?
Oh. That means where to.
In the lap of the mountain, we're too. What it?
Are they trying to tell us where they are with the eggs?
Well, I know that there's a huge mountain over there that's pretty close to where their old castle used to be. What have we got to lose? We gotta check out where, what's going on over there. Come on, guys, to the slingshot.
All right, boys, come on.
Oh my god.
They destroyed the slingshot.
What are we supposed to do now?
I guess we just have to walk over there and face them ourselves.
But if they're hiding in a structure, how are we gonna get through it?
I guess we're just gonna have to do it the hard way. Alright guys, it's this way. Follow me.
Alright, guys.
Welcome to Porkgrind Grove. The transition area from Ramon Jungle to Piggy Plains. So, that fountain that they're probably talking about is west, so we just gotta, you know, keep going this way.
Alright, come on, guys.
Go on, Matilda.
Hey, Bomb, before we keep going, can I have a quick word with you? Hey, where's Bomb and Matilda?
They're still behind us.
Come on, guys, let's go.
Matilda, we should probably get moving. Come on.
Look at all this volcanic ash. We're definitely entering mountainous terrain. All right, guys, follow me.
We are never doing a bird strike again. Hey, I need a boost. Come on.
Don't worry, nephew.
Private Jeremy, come here.
What is it, sir? Those birds, they covered through the Porkgrind Grove. Here, I have a telegraph that you need to give to the Corporal, just westward. Alright, here, give me it. Okay, now. Here it is. It has everything that needs to be said. Wait with the Corporal until you have words that he needs to say to me. So, go off now, go off.
Yes, sir. I'll try to get to them as fast as possible.
Alright. Private Alex.
Yes, sir.
Follow Private Jeremy. Make sure he delivers that message in one piece. And also make sure he doesn't do anything stupid.
Yes, sir. I'm gonna sneak behind him.
Very good, then.
And stay on the path of those birds. Oh, they're gone now. Godspeed.
We've been hiking for hours.
I know.
I had dirt all over my face and I can't even run anymore. I'm too exhausted.
Guys, how would it sound if we stopped for a minute to stretch our legs?
Definitely. Come on, guys.
That sounds like a plan to me. All right, well, I know a good spot. Come on.
Come on, Matilda. We get to rest. Right behind you, Bomb.
Yeah, paradise.
Hello, guys. Well, what are we waiting for?
Water. Sweet, sweet water.
It's so refreshing.
This is just what I needed.
Yeah. It's rather romantic. Isn't it, Bomb?
What? I mean, it's rather gigantic, like this huge bowl of water. Oh, yeah. It's pretty big.
What am I doing wrong? Hey, Red. Hey, Madonna.
So, I can see that you have a thing for Bomb?
How'd you know?
It wasn't so obvious, was it?
What?
You're joking, right?
No.
Yeah, it was pretty dang obvious.
Do you have any advice? Well, Matilda, you come to the right guy. Well, really, the right guy has come to you, but yeah, I've got a few tricks up my sleeve.
Well, like I'm not gay or anything, right? You know, I don't really like guys, but like you know, I know what a guy wants, you know, because you know, I am a guy. And, you know, I'm your friend, and I'm willing to give you a few tricks.
Tell me everything.
Okay, let's get further away from everyone else, shall we? Come on.
Yeah.
Alright, so now that you know the rules, let's get playing. 3v1. I already know I'm gonna beat you all.
Yeah, we'll see about that. Come on, bring some.
Yeah, okay. What the hell was wrong with this ball?
Okay, fine, we'll get the first serve. What? Boys, help me out here. Hey, Jake, you too. Come on, Jake, get in the ball. Put a little effort into it, Jake, God. This thing won't budge. What's up with it?
Chuck, help us out with it.
Wait a minute. This isn't even a ball. It's a rock.
And this is like the stuff that they put inside of speakers and in microphones. But what's going on here?
What's a microphone?
I don't know.
Me neither.
And yeah, that's pretty much all I know. Wow, Red, that's a lot of info to take down.
Yeah, I know.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Oh, Red. Something strange is going on. This ball was like placed here seemingly intentionally, and yeah, this guy says that some sort of microphone material or whatever is inside of it. A little fishy.
What's a microphone?
I don't know. What's a speaker?
I don't know what any of that is.
Do you think this place is like a setup or something?
What makes you say that? Well, I mean, look at it all. It's just too good to be true. Yeah.
Red, haven't you been here before? No? What makes you say that? You said that you knew a spot where we could stretch our legs and you brought us here. That happened? Yes, you said that.
Yeah, that's true, you did say that. I didn't even know that this place existed, I swear.
How did you even know how to get here?
I don't know. Wait a minute. Like, shh, listen. Something's coming out of this ball. A weird noise.
Hey, I hear it too.
Alright guys. They're getting a little suspicious about our ball speaker.
Private. Yes, Sergeant? Any word from that messenger from Sergeant James? Not yet, Sergeant.
Where could he be? Was he killed by the birds?
I don't know, Sergeant. Engage. Hey guys, I'm here with the telegraph.
You're a little late. No, I don't want that telegraph. That telegraph's supposed to go to the corporal. I'm supposed to give you another telegraph. Now hurry your ass up and get to the corporal before those birds get there.
Yeah, Trey, don't rush me.
Actually, Sergeant, give me the telegraph. Give me both the telegraphs, because this guy's actually my responsibility.
Okay. Why'd they even send him? They didn't want him to think that he was useless. They didn't want to hurt his old feelings. Alright, we should probably get going. Come on now. Alright, yeah, good seeing you. Come on now. Yeah, I heard. Jesus Christ.
That's what dragged us over here. That's what drew me in here.
So this is a setup, Matilda. By the pigs, most likely.
They're trying to waste our time. Or, you know, they're trying to get us to waste our own time. All right, we need to get out of here fast. We need to find that mountain. It's over there. Bomb.
Huh?
Come on.
All right, come on now. We have to get to the corporal before it gets dark and for those birds find us.
I'm right behind you, Jesus Christ. Oh my gosh, the bodies.
Well, wait, where? Shit.
We have to take over. Come on.
Come on now, you fat low. Wait a minute. I'm saying hi to the birdies. Hi, birdies. We're going on a secret mission. Catch us if you can. Da-da-da-da-da.
It's a pig. Come on. Oh, God, the telegraph.
Huh? What's this? some sort of paper with words on it, and I can't read it.
Matilda, can you decipher this? It's red, and the words on there are like red and stuff. Can you, like, you know, is that like pig Latin?
Okay, well, let's see. This is just gibberish. Those pigs are super illiterate. I have no idea what's wrong with most of them.
Oh, that could have really helped us. Guys, I'm getting answers out of this guy. What, really? Hold on.
No. No, don't hurt me, please. He's just literally on the mountain over there. See?
Wait, that's the mountain? It's just right there?
Yes.
Well, thank you so much for your cooperation, kind sir. Alright guys, you heard him. Let's go.
Alright, just get comfortable now. But I'm not even his wife.
I know, but you look so much like Queen Melissa that you might as well, you know, help out tricking the birds, looking, helping the hoax look more realistic, you know? So, yeah.
I don't get paid enough to do this. Those birds aren't even gonna come. We broke their slingshots, right?
That's right, sweetheart. We ain't got nothing to worry about. No birds here tonight. Quentin, what's that? Those anger birds. I can't see your faces.
Just wait to look on their faces. When they get a glimpse of this punchline. Yeah, isn't that right, my king?
Alright guys, we've been spotted. Let's go ahead and make this quick. Let's climb up that mountain. Let's get that corporal a piece of our mind.
I thought the king would be here. They're gonna get it off the edge like that. Where even is he?
I think it's that bigger helmet pig.
Oh.
Yeah, it's definitely that one. He's wearing body armor to protect himself. Just wait until he gets a load of us this time.
Whoops.
Yeah, you daft pig.
Look out!
Oh my god, that blue guy's about to hit me!
Oh god! I'm all out of troops!
Take this, King Pig! Wait a minute. What's wrong with
that
King Pig?
Alright, Corporal. Where are the eggs? Tell us now!
Oh no! The worthless, powerless rubber is attacking me! Let's see how I like it this time!
King Pig! Should have done this a long time ago. Okay, let's make this fast and easy. You, I've already lost. Now surrender the eggs. Where are they? Come on! Tell us where they are! I'm warning you. I'm gonna be the last face you see. If you don't tell us where the eggs are. Come on! Come on! Come on! That's the only one. Alright. I warned you. We'll look for the eggs ourselves.
Ah.
Wait a minute. This does not feel like pig flesh. It's just a little cutout. Guys, this isn't King Pig. It isn't a pig at all, actually.
Wait, what?
Huh, so that's what was weird about it.
Huh? It truly isn't a pig. Corporal!
Alright, Corporal. This is your last warning. Where are the eggs?
Okay. I'm cooperating now. Look, you buried the eggs right under this rock. Here they are.
Just a container.
What do you mean? Well, there's some paper in it. Corporal, what are you trying to pull here? He's gone.
Okay.
Let's take this to Matilda.
Okay, let's get this thing open.
Might need an extra hand opening this. Wait on, there's a crack. It's like cracking an egg.
There's just a bunch of paper. All these papers have the same gibberish on them too, except for this one. This one has some numbers on it. What do the numbers mean? I don't know. Wait a minute. They're coordinates. The coordinates to another location. Well, I mean, I would hope. Maybe this could be where the actual King Pig is.
Well, how do we know where to go with just those coordinates? I mean, we don't really have a map or anything.
Yeah, Jim has a point. How are we gonna do this?
I can do it.
What?
I can do this. There's like a map, like, in my brain. My uncle was a cartographer, and he taught me everything I know. So, yeah, just give me that little, piece of paper, and, yeah, I can take you there.
Yeah, here, Mom.
Thanks.
What are you doing? Giving him the paper, Red. Why? I don't know, maybe to, you know, boost my chances with him? This is bad. This is just a horrible time for that, Matilda. We need to find our eggs.
Yes, and this could be our chance to find them. Bob might actually be right about, you know, having that, you know, map brain thing. So, for this time, let's listen to Bob. 5, 6, 15. That's what this thing says. Let's go over here first.
All right, let's get the show on the road. So, I believe it is almost time to have our deal be completed. So how does that sound with you fellas? Well, sir, that's why we came down here, so let's wrap this whole thing up.
We weren't talking to you, Pigsworth, we were talking to Quarterpounder over here.
Now, Commander Porterhouse. But we would like to hear your thoughts on all this, Quarterpounder.
Oh, very well. I'm just ready for all this to be over. Professor Pigsworth over here is planning to do another surgery on me. Maybe can put me back to normal. And I won't have to do all the suffering anymore.
I guess getting more than half of the portion of the eggs is a nice change of pace. I might really need this. Well, let me tell you something, kid. You really earned it. Ah, no, here comes our chef. Yeah.
Alright, gentlemen. Bon appetit. The eggs aren't yet poached, but yeah, I know that one of you is going to take two of these home, so I might as well just get them out now, you know?
Yes, exactly. Just like how I commanded you.
Yes, Mr. Pigsworth. Whatever. Oh, before you go. Yes, my king? Could you take off the lid? Oh, yes. Yeah. I think these eggs might need a bit of sanitation before I just hand them out to you.
Then go back and sanitize them, Chef! We're not trying to poison them!
Yeah, I know. Okay, Jesus Christ. I'll be back in a minute.
Okay, so right now, I think it'd be a good time to say that I actually don't necessarily care if you're suffering or in so much pain. Look at me, I'm Russian. I don't care about that.
What do you say?
I'm saying you nearly got those birds out of the park. You can do it again, just one more time, and then I'll give you those two eggs.
What? Such insolence, especially from you, King Smoothcheeks. I would never expect you to say something like this. Such an insult. It's just such disrespect. My glasses. Don't do this bullshit with me again. Okay, whatever. I would never expect royalty like you to say something like that.
I did it to Foreman Fuzzstache, and I can do it to whoever the hell I please.
The Foreman was right about you. You're corrupt, King. You're one who deceives. That's such a horrible king to be.
Come on, Quarterpounder. Where do you think you're going?
I've had just about enough of your bullshit, King Pig. Now come on, Quarterpounder.
Quarterpounder? What?
I cannot believe what I'm seeing. Even after he just totally insulted you, you stick with him because you're afraid. Okay, fine. Be that way. I'm gonna have to pack up my things. Damn this kingdom.
Mutiny! You're committing treason! You're a traitor, you're a heretic!
Do you know what they do to people like you?
I would hope they kill me. Like how you probably insist. That fate would be better than living a life like this daily with everyone spitting in your face. Go piss off, King Smoothcheeks.
Now we need someone to get this fiend!
No. We've damned him enough. What he's doing now, stab him right in the back. Now, Quarterpounder, let's get back down to business.
Two eggs. If you get rid of those birds.
King Smoothcheeks!
Yes, Commander Porterhouse.
We have still yet to hear from the messenger that was sent out by Sergeant James.
Some of these pigs, some of their just stupidity, I just can't measure just how angered I am by it. Though that's probably a good thing. No rebellion starting right under my snout, I can sniff it. Some of these pigs are so stupid that they just won't even dare to listen to what that foreman or what that Pigsworth has to say. Wait a minute. That's what herdism is. Oh no.
My king? Are you right up there?
Yes, Commander. I'm afraid those birds have something to do with the muteness of the corporal and that messenger.
Yeah. Those birds do put up a fight.
Wait a minute.
Sir?
This just might be another dumb idea, but... Think about it. It could solve all of our conflicts. Well, resolve all our conflicts. This just might... You might look at me like a fool when I say this, but... During this time of giving thanks, I think this might be a good time to give a peace offering of some sort.
What? We can't make amends with those birds. They'll think that we're insane.
We're all insane the head here, Commander Porterhouse. Now give me a blank sheet of paper. I have a treaty to write.
Let's hike ever end. Alright. Roughly a mile away from the old castle is, I guess, the new castle, guys.
Whoa. It's pretty tall.
Yeah, it is pretty tall, but I don't think it's as big as that other castle. That castle went down underground, like, very, very deep. So, all right. Let's try to do a heist.
Yeah.
Try to do a heist. That's the whole reason we're here. We're going to do the heist.
I'm so glad it's almost over. Hey, Bomb, that was really smart of you, deciphering where the castle was.
Oh, thanks, Matilda. I've always had it in me. I've always known how to locate where things are with coordinations and all that. Like I said, my uncle is a cartographer, and I learned everything I know from him.
Yeah, I heard.
Hey, Bomb, do you think that you, when we're done with this, do you think there could be a time where we,
Oh, great.
There's a big gate, and now to get through it.
Oh boy. Yeah, it's gonna set us back a few minutes.
Perhaps I can be of assistance.
Red, I think we might have a little bit of a problem.
Huh? Oh. So you're the commander that we've heard of. You really think we're afraid of you? We're gonna blast right through you.
You were saying?
In case if you didn't know, we pigs have given a name for you. You are known as the Angry Birds. Why is that? Well, that's bit of a good question, actually. You've caused ultimate destruction. And, you boys seem pretty outraged by our questionable actions.
Yeah, they're pretty damn questionable. I mean, you just steal our eggs and you're gonna kill our friends? Why would you do something like that?
It's called developing a kingdom. You aren't kings, but, that red one, he seems like the most upstanding one of all of you. I'm pretty sure he is the one with the most leadership skills.
Yeah, I mean, I am the leader of this bunch.
Yes, anyways, you would know what it's like. If you have a kingdom, you must evolve it somehow. You must expand that empire, and there's no other way than
destroying the lives of millions of innocent people.
Yes, you understand. You actually understand. I'm actually kind of glad.
You're awful, you know that? I mean, you're literally admitting to this.
There we go, that doesn't take the biscuit. Look who's talking. You literally wrecked all of our houses, and you just took away the careers and the livelihoods of all of my innocent civilians. So I don't want to hear that shit come out of your mouth, or your beak, if you will.
And we wouldn't have done that if you didn't strike first, killing all of our bird friends and snatching our eggs.
And what if we did it? What if it was you that did it? What if we destroyed your nest by flinging ourselves in a giant slingshot, destroying everything that you love?
You already have.
So it's vengeance you want. Well, I also have my reasons as well. And that is why we need to stop this. We need to put this conflict behind us. We need to settle this once and for all right now. Together, I'm sure that we can become the most powerful force in this whole damn universe.
Universe? I don't know about that.
Just right there, little one. Yes, in the whole universe. We live in one of the many universes of the Gearverse. There are a few powerful beings among this Gearverse. One being a Batman. Two of them being these cup brothers with cups on their heads, running around shooting weird magical blasts from their index finger.
And then there's our world. There's you, with your remarkable abilities.
And there's also a large group of plants that either shoot bullets from their little pores, or they can emit sun from their petals. There's all shapes and sizes of powerful friends and foes in this Gearverse.
And if you understand this, then that'd be great. The birds and the bad piggies combined can create an unstoppable force. We'll be able to take down all of those posers. We can become the ultimate, most powerful
kingdom and the entire Gearverse.
It can't be done. Our chemistry is too bad. We just want to fight all these people.
And that, my chicken fellow, is where we're going to start turning over our new leaves. Commander, flip over this paper.
Yes, sir!
And also, as you can see here, your eggs sit untouched. You can have them back if you sign this peace treaty where the X's are.
I've already signed my name. You just gotta pick up the pen.
I'll get it. You just pick up the pen and you sign your names.
Here it is. You should probably sign it first. Because, you know, you're the leader and all that.
Excuse me, Jim.
And if I don't sign this simple piece of paper, what happens?
Then you're establishing inevitable war among our two kingdoms.
Whoops.
Oh no, my reflex is slimy.
I'll get it.
Oh no, my reflexes. I'm so sorry about that.
It's okay, I guess. Quarterpounder, get the pin.
Just a second. I think these birds are up to no good, boss.
Guys, come on, do something.
Red, what are you doing? This tree right here can mean peace for all of us at last. We don't have to fight anymore.
Matilda, this whole time they've been tricking us. Now it's our time to trick them.
Hey, King Pig, why is there a big old shit stain on your wall?
What? Oh, I guess there is a bit of a shit stain on my wall.
I actually kind of want to see the shit stain.
Yeah, that's kind of weird. I should probably get that cleaned up. Wait, where are the eggs? Wait, what? Yeah, where are the eggs? Where did my precious eggs go? Huh.
Oh, I know. It's that damn chef pig coming in here unannounced. Ugh.
Oh, yeah. Curse that chef pig. Hey, we're going to sign this now. We found the pin. All right, guys. Come on. Yeah, let's sign it.
Your Majesty, I think they're crumbling up the paper.
Nonsense. They're definitely signing it. I mean, listen to that. That's the sound of signing a paper.
What a neat way of handing it back to me. So neat and so tidy. Okay.
Guys, come on over, give me a hand.
I'll just put that in my office.
Woohoo, yeah, we did it!
No, you haven't done it yet. You forgot about me. I should have killed you when I had the chance. You made me suffer. Immense amounts of pain. I can't take it anymore. You must be destroyed. All of you.
Oh boy.
Come on, guys, let's go!
Come in.
Come on, guys.
Richard, don't forget about me!
So, little birdie. You stay to fight.
Yep, pretty much. Ow. It's pretty good, tough guy. Hey, that's cheating.
So, little one, have you had enough yet? No, not any more suffering.
Hey, there's the cap.
The what? No.
No, make it stop.
Damn, that was kind of metal. Now let's get the hell out of here.
I need to do some sort of cleansing after that. I don't know if it's mental or physical.
Ha, Professor Pigsworth. We've been expecting you.
Long time no see, Foreman Fuzzstache. I feel as if it would be the best decision to listen to your wisdom and, you know, separate from King Pig's corrupt kingdom.
Well, I'm glad you made up your mind about it. So, is it official?
Actually, not yet. There are still a few things I need to do before I officially secede. I need to perform one final surgery on Quarterpounder to make him happy. And I also need to secure some documents. Then I can finally, you know, team up with you guys. Then I shall have peace within my mind.
Ah, well, what are these documents that you speak of, Pigsworth?
Oh boy, they're blueprints to a flying machine. I developed them about 9 years ago. I'm trying to hide them so that King Smoothcheeks doesn't discover them and or Commander Porterhouse, so that they don't unleash another attack upon any other bird settlements. If they keep doing this, then it's just gonna be eternal conflict.
Well, unfortunately, I hate to say that I think it might be a little too late to secure those documents.
What makes you say that, Fuzzstache?
Well, I was the main foreman for constructing the flying machine, and secretly, King Smoothcheeks commanded that we should get a head start on it. We started building it around 5 years ago, and I think right now it's almost completed with its construction.
Oh my god, such disrespect! Another good reason to completely leave King Pig in his kingdom. He lied to me. He said he'd wait until my approval. Just wait. We'll get him back, right?
Oh, yes. We'll certainly get him back. He's treated us all wrongly. I feel like it would just be a treat. We deserve it. To get him back. Right in the ass. Yes. Well, let's start thinking now.
Bad feeling about this. It's gonna be a harsh winter. Yeah, especially with those pigs. Yeah, you sure said it. You know, dealing with the pigs this time is significantly easier than last time. Because last time we had to ram our heads through a bunch of buildings. And as we can see here, can do that this time. So let's be grateful that that wasn't the main problem. Yeah. It's kind of weird how King Pig almost gave in. I nearly gave in too, but I just don't trust him at all. Yeah, me neither. Let's head back to the nest.
Now I know that those pigs will come back.
Yeah. Maybe not as strong since, you know, seeing last time Mao. The king nearly gave in.
No, were any of you listening? He said that inevitable eternal war will be among us if we didn't sign that peace treaty, and we didn't. We slapped him in the face again. They are gonna come back stronger. They're gonna be on our asses, guys.
Is that true, Red?
She has a point. She's right. Yeah. And also, when we were leaving, I sped by a little hangar room of sorts, and I saw this big contraption made out of some sort of metallic material. I don't know what it was, but it looked dangerous. It looked like some sort of tank. We should probably get our minds off of this for now. Yeah, we probably should. I think we might need to move. You know, it just might be for the better.